So let me show you how to do a quick analysis of a structure with weldments and sheet metal. Over here I have made a sample sketch in plane. Now I'd like to make it a 3D. So I usually use sketch 3D to make a structure, but I could do this even if you know the coordinates of your planes and of your points. Let me do this. Let me make a sketch on top plane. Always remember to join the nodes to the nodes which you are working on. If they're not connected, the members end up getting hanging in between midair. We have this relation here. Some weldment. I may need to refresh that. Okay, so I am hoping you know how to create custom weldment profiles. So I'm selecting each member. Over here I have used square tube 20 by 20 2mm thick. Apply the sketch. Okay. Well, you can see there are like a lot of spaces over here which might not reflect how you actually want your model to be. So to use that feature, we usually use something called trim. You can find this trim feature in weldment. If you go to insert, go to weldments and you have trim/extend. Just click it, and basically what you're trying to do with this is you are trying to have your members scope perfectly. Then need not be, you know, like this. Obviously it's impossible to weld like this, and it won't be structurally good if you use something like this. So basically you want to have it this full completely member. So you might have to play around with this a lot of time. For example, you see this. So now this happens and you say, okay, I don't want this. You say something like this if you want. Okay. So this is creating a problem with me dealing with this. Okay, so basically you want something like that. Okay, you do that for even this. And let me do that. So you have like different miters over here. See, when you select this, you basically extend this tube, and on the inside face you have this. It's very different than this corner miter. See, this is corner miter, this is end butt. So depending on your choice, you can have any of the miters available. Just make sure that there is no space between two members like this. So to fix this, you have to go ahead and tell him you don't want to give any weld spaces, something like this, and when you click OK, it will join it for you. This looks odd somehow. Anyways, we could do that for this even, but I'm thinking this is almost correct. Let me see, even small spaces are removed. They get pretty neat, and so you might have to play around with this a lot of times. You know, you might have to do multiple of these trim extents. Don't worry, take your time. Just be sure that all your joints are correctly profiled, cope, and there are no spaces between them and they intersect. That's the main point. You see, I'm seeing these both are intersected, so I might want to leave those. So are these. So let us do just analysis on weldments, then we can go ahead for the with cassettes and sheet metal in between the two members. So as you can see on this left hand side plane, you primarily first off, it will show you all the members over here. See this. So you can just right click and make them, of course you have to apply a so after you have selected the material of your choice, might be in my case I'm using alloy steel. I'm specifying the number of nodes. I would select all, okay. Then calculate. It calculates these many joints. So basically, there are these many joints over here, like this 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, and then hit OK. Now you have to specify if your members are connected or bonded together or not. You do that in connections. Right click on connections. Now you go to fixtures, let's say fix geometry. Now because you are doing beam analysis, you are allowed to touch or select only nodes. You see this symbol are designated for joints or nodes. Okay, now let us select any of these two nodes basically. This joint 1, 1. Okay, I've selected two nodes. I've fixed them. They are fixed geometry, then you have immovable node translation. I'll go with fixed geometry. Then the next step would be to put nodes. Let me give create some arbitrary node here. Now you always have to select node, or you can even select on the length of the beam. In this case, I'll just select the nodes, these two nodes. You have to give the direction along which the force is propagated. Just for the reference, I'll just select top plane over here. Then it gives you an option parallel to, perpendicular to in the plane. Now this gives along the plane. You select it, it will show you direction. So you can select whichever you want. In my case, I'll just push it like this. And I'll give you create a mesh. In this case, you have the options to create more finer mesh. You see, this because this is a beam element, it takes in account of your section modulus, moment of inertia in the beam property itself. The matrix has taken care of all those coefficients which you have given in your weldments. That's why the mesh appears like this, because it's a beam element. We can go ahead and make it more fine if you want. Okay, create a mesh. You see, you can apply mesh control if you want this side to have more finer mesh than the others. Then, satisfied with your mesh and with your loads and constraints, you can go ahead and hit run. Okay. Let me make this more legible. Click on this and I go to the bottom and say I want floating numbers. Okay. Now you see the stress, because the beam, this is the beam element and it will not have one VC stress as you might have seen in other analysis. This usually have a bending stress and a normal stress. That's why it has a bending. Over here we are specifying the bending stress. You could see the displacement, and this is just an arbitrary values. It may not be like that. Now if you would want to, however, change the type of stress you want, you can go ahead and go with upper bound bending stress. Because as we know, this is beam elements. And you can go ahead with in direction 2. This upper bound axial and bending, this one would be your torsion. Okay. You could always define a factor of safety plot for your structure. You say include all the bodies. Okay. Okay. So you are like way above your factor of safety. No, that's fine. This is an example. So over here you're getting erratic values. So this is how you do the analysis on beam elements when you have only weldments in your structure.